Fridtjof Nansen was born on October 10, 1861, in Christiania, also known as Oslo, which is the capital of Norway. 1881, Nansen was accepted into University of Oslo. He excelled in the science branches and in drawing. He decided to major in zoology. Nansen, 15 years later, found his drive for adventure and his passion for science continued. 1888, the six-man expedition set forth in June. Also, only July 17th, the men left the safety of the ship, expecting to get to land in 2 to 3 days, which actually ended up to be 12 long days surviving temperatures of negative 50 degrees Celsius and exhaustion. Not until July 29th were they able to step foot on land. 300 miles south of their original plan, they mastered dangerous ice, reaching open waters until late September. Finally, they reached the west coast. The team was left with important information about the new discovered land. The beginning. Nansen began his exploration in 1893. He was trying to reach the North Pole through the Arctic Ocean's east to west current. He sailed on a ship he had built called the Fram. The current he was traveling in was known to be difficult because of the westerly winds. Nansen and his team set sail. Nansen was discouraged to carry out this expedition from the very beginning. Polar explorers warned him of the conditions he would experience. The ship froze into ice of the Arctic Ocean. After 18 months of the slow drift carrying them, they decided to abandon the ship and continued toward the North Pole with their dogs and sledges. Nansen's unexpected discovery during his expedition was ending up at Franz Josef Land. This was an accomplishment because the Franz Josef Land is known for its mysterious spherical stones littered across the island. During his expedition, Nansen gathered knowledge on ocean currents, glaciers, sea ice, and climate. Nansen's trip was a success, even though the Fram did not drift as close to the North Pole as he hoped. Nansen and his companion had gotten closer to the North Pole than anyone else had to that date. Another one of Nansen's accomplishments is that the ship he designed to drift the Arctic current did exactly what it was made to do. Nansen died May 13th in 1930. On May 17th, he is buried on Norway's Constitution Day.